Hey, what's up, garden friends? How's everybody doing? Time to throw together a couple more fall planters. I picked up these two wooden box containers from Michael's Crafts. They were on sale, buy one, get one, so obviously I jumped on top of that. And what I've done here is I've gone ahead and I have lined these with plastic, kind of trimmed it to fit as best as I could, and then popped a hole in the bottom, pulled that plastic through it, and cut a hole in it. The extra safe probably could have put some type of like weather protectant on this. I'm gonna be keeping these in kind of a sheltered place, so I'm not too terribly concerned about it. It may look like I've already finished these, but I haven't. So far, I've really just kind of mocked them up. I like to lay things out and get an idea of what I'm doing before I dive right in and start planting things. That being said, I have a pretty good idea of what I wanna do here, so I'm gonna go ahead and jump in here and start planting. And there it is. For some reason, my camera wasn't recording when I planted up the smaller one, so sorry about that. Not that it matters. You know what I did. I took plants and I put them in there. I did originally have this one planted up with a La Coffee in the center, and I had to pull that out because I realized that the La Coffees do not like full sun, and everything else in here is going to want sun. Sometimes just have to adjust. Not a big deal. Over here in the larger planter in the back is a Croton that is a tropical zone 10 and up, hardy to about 35, 40 degrees. It's not going to stay outside all year. It won't survive. You just pick those up usually from like the terrarium section at your Lowe's or Home Depot. They're pretty easy to find. Over here to the right of that Croton, that's the Heuchera Dulce Cinnamon Curls from Proven Winners. Excellent option to have plants in here with the Croton because they can go sun or shade. The foliage is absolutely beautiful. It's nice, crisp, brown, cinnamony red on top. And the underside of the leaves have that really pretty crimsony red kind of pinkish color. I just named off a whole bunch of different colors. It's pretty. In the center, I kind of smashed one of the fiber optic grasses in there. It just adds a little bit of texture that I really like. These are fall planters. They're not going to be together for a super long time, so I'm not really that concerned about overcrowding. The spillers, these are Creeping Jenny on each side here. And then here in the center, and it needs some help filling out, same as the one I put in the other one. That is a Calibrachoa. It's an orange one called Cabaret. Annuals are slim thickens where I live this time of year, so it's the best I could get. As time goes on, it doesn't look centered. It is. As time goes on, that'll fill out more. The orange is going to pop a lot, and it's going to kind of draw things together with the Croton in the back. I like that a lot. And then the smaller of the planters, looking quite as good as the big one in my personal opinion, but in the back that is a Magellan mixed zinnia. Nice yellows and pinks and oranges in there. Really like zinnias. They're kind of like sunflowers and daisies. They're just sort of happy and cheery. Bees and butterflies, all the pollinators really like them too. And then just to kind of tie things together a little bit more to get some more darker colors in here, that is a Coleus who doesn't have a tag. I grabbed one that doesn't have a tag. I'm so sorry. I remember it was one that stays a little bit smaller and goes sun or shade. And in the front, looking kind of messy and shabby on each side, Lemon Coral Sedums, and then another one of those orange Cabaret Calibrachoas in the center. The reason I pulled the La Coffee out of here is because, like I'd mentioned, I want this to be in really bright, intense sun because that's going to compact the growth on these Lemon Coral Sedums a little bit. They'll tidy up. They'll look a lot nicer. So Lemon Coral Sedums are kind of what I consider like a garden thug. They grow like crazy. So I am going to have to be mindful to make sure that they don't choke out the Calibrach that's here in the center. Oh, and I almost forgot. I have some little fake pumpkins here. I'm going to toss those in there too. That's better. Don't know how. I almost forgot to put those in there. Small embellishments doesn't make a huge change to the planters, but I do like them in there. Sometimes when I'm not putting cabbage or kale or mums in something, it is sort of nice to put something in there just like let people know it's for fall. In my head, fall planters have to be cabbage, kale, mums, which I'm trying to get away from. I'm doing those in some other planters. I like them a lot and they do have their place, but sometimes it's nice to just use little embellishments and things like that, just sort of sweeten it up a little bit. But there it is, quick, simple, just throwing things together, trying to get some contrast, some plants that'll do well in the cool. The Croton, of course, will have to come in. Calibrachs, I have noticed, sometimes do just fine when temperatures start to cool off a little bit, which is nice. I like this one a lot better than that one. Just saying, you don't always love it. If I had succulents, I would actually want to do the smaller one with succulents, but I don't have enough and I don't really feel like spending the money on them right now. I think that would have looked really cool. As this coleus and everything fills out and starts to bloom, I will like this a lot more. It needs to grow and then it will grow on me.
No, but I hope everybody's doing well. Don't forget to leave the video a thumbs up. It helps a ton. I really appreciate every single one of those. Thank you so much. Subscribe as well. It's actually down there. Upload multiple times a week. I'll have all my social media linked down below, down there in the description. Follow me and I'll follow you back. I love looking at everybody's plant pictures and seeing what y'all have going on in your gardens. As always, everybody, most importantly, keep on growing. Bye-bye.